When you have your customer on a voice call, you have their undivided attention. Why not use that opportunity to tell them the latest news about your company, relay an inspiring message from your CEO, or even just play them your latest advertising jingle? In this tutorial, you will learn how to play an audio file into an active call programmatically using the Vonage Voice API, Node.js, and the Express framework. Before getting started, you'll need some knowledge of JavaScript, Node.js installed on your machine, and a Vonage API account for your API credentials. Finally, you'll want the source code, which is available on GitHub. Clone the repository and CD into the application's root directory. Now, let's install the Nexmo CLI using the following command. Configure the CLI with your API key and secret, which you'll find as soon as you log in to the Vonage Developer Dashboard. You'll need a number to make calls from, so let's rent one by executing the following command, replacing the country code as appropriate. For example, if you're in the US, replace CA with US. Do make a note of the telephone number that the command returns. To use the Voice API, you must create a Voice API application. This is not the same thing as the web application you are building. It's merely a container for the configuration and security information you need to connect to the Vonage APIs. Create an application using the CLI and make a note of the application ID it returns. Note that the app create command shown uses a few parameters. These are to set the webhook endpoints and download your private key to authenticate your application. The Vonage APIs need to know your webhook endpoints so that they can make requests to them when there's an incoming call or an event that your application should know about. You can safely leave these as example.com because we will specify the webhooks programmatically. The application has several external dependencies which are configured in package.json. Run npm install to install them to the node module subdirectory. The dependencies include .env, a module that allows us to easily configure the application using an env file, Express, a lightweight web framework, Body Parser, which is middleware to handle post requests, and Nexmo, the REST client library for Node.js. Now we need to expose our application to the internet so that the Nexmo servers can access our webhooks. We recommend using ngrok for this. Follow the instructions in the blog post link below to install and run ngrok on port 3000. Ngrok will give you a temporary URL. Make sure you make a note of it. Do leave ngrok running while you're using the application. Otherwise, the URLs will change and you'll need to reconfigure it. Now, copy example.env to env and enter the details you've harvested from the above steps. Then, change the path to the audio file in the answer.json package to match your ngrok host name. You are now ready to see the application in action. Launch the application by executing the following command, node server.js. Visit localhost 3000/call in your browser. This makes a GET request to the call endpoint in your application and causes it to ring the to number in env. You will hear a message, followed by some music that plays for 20 seconds, and then the call disconnects. So how does this all work? All the logic happens in server.js. Let's run through the code there now. The application first reads the settings you configured in env into environment variables and uses them to instantiate the Nexmo REST API client library for Node.js. We use two audio files in this application. One is for the music that we play to the caller. The other is a silent MP3 file. You can only play audio into an existing call, so it's important that we keep the call open, otherwise it will disconnect before you have a chance to do anything with it. The silent MP3 file keeps the call open. The welcome message and silent MP3 are defined in a Nexmo call control object, or NCCO for short. The NCCO is an array of JSON objects that represents the actions that occur within the call. Our answer.json NCCO tells the application to read some text and then stream a silent MP3. This is one way of streaming audio into a call, but the focus of this tutorial is how to do it programmatically. These resources are served from the application's public directory as follows. When we make a GET request to the call route, the application uses the Nexmo client library's callsCreate method to make an outbound call to the to number configured in env. When the call is answered, it responds with the actions defined in answer.json NCCO and starts listening to voice API events on the webhooks events webhook handler. In the event webhook, we check the call status. If it is answered, then we retrieve the call ID so that we can play the audio into the correct call and stop playing the audio after 20 seconds. After the audio is stopped, we use the Nexmo calls update method to replace the existing NCCO action with a new one, hang up, which disconnects the call. The start stream function uses the Nexmo client library's callsStreamStart method to programmatically play the specified audio file into the call. The stop stream function calls Nexmo callsStreamStop to stop playing the audio file. In this tutorial, you learned how to play audio into an existing call and about some of the NCCO actions that govern the call flow. Feel free to now experiment by substituting different audio files and NCCO actions. If you have any questions, please post them below. Until next time, thanks for watching!